It's all like in the Trinity Park, go right around.
I'll let you all know, Father Gregory Maslach is pastor here at St. Mary Ukrainian Catholic Church, and Charlie Schultz will be assisting him, hopefully to be a deacon pretty soon, another couple months maybe. And I'm sure if you have any questions to ask him, he'll explain what's going on as permitted.
I'm always praying for everybody that's in the military or helps us, that protects us. And that means policemen, because we get married. I think four policemen here in Philadelphia. The last one was, I forget, McDonald? Was it McDonald or was it a no? It was one that he got killed. Was it McDonald?
McDonald.
Yeah. And what do you call it? So when I'm thinking of the soldiers, I'm especially thinking of you, Dominic.
Oh, thank you.
I hope you don't, nothing happens, no trouble at all.
Yeah, don't cause any trouble.
Are you protected?
Yes, I'm well protected. I'm well protected.
Look at this one with his rosary. He liked that the last time he was who is Charles
Baptist? They have the three long kids.
They have the twins. You like the rosary?
No.
Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit is glorified now and forever. Let us pray to the Lord. The holy and awesome glory of God, incomprehensible, insearchable in all his ways, works and in all his strength, and who has preordained you, O devil, to the penalty of eternal separation from him. He is again incomprehensible and insearchable in all his works and in all his strength. And he commands you and all of your cohort to us, his unworthy servants, even now, to go forth from him, Dominic John, who has been newly sealed in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the true God. Therefore, I charge you, most evil, abominable, loathsome, and unclean alien spirit, by the power of Jesus Christ, who has all authority in heaven and upon earth, the command of the deaf and the dumb, get out of the man and enter him no more. Depart. Confess the vainness of your might, which has no power over even swine. Remember him who bade you and your own at your own request to enter into the herd of swine. And as God let you go into the swine, they were destroyed. Hear God, by whose decree the earth was established upon the waters, who bounded the heavens and fixed the mountains with a plumb line and the valleys with a measure, who has placed the sand for a boundary to the sea and made sea paths through the waters, who touches the mountains in the smoke, who clothes himself with light as with a garment, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain, and who covers the upper rooms with waters, establishes the earth on our firm foundations, never to be moved, who draws the water of the sea and sprinkles it upon the face of the earth, allows us to depart from him who is now being made ready for holy baptism. I assure you that the Lord God has power over you, our Lord Jesus Christ. And I assure you by his saving passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, by his precious body and blood, and by his awesome second coming again, for he shall come without delay to judge all the earth and punish you and your cohorts in the fiery Gehenna, surrendering you to outer darkness forever, where dominion and power belongs to the Lord God, to Christ our God, with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray to the Lord. The Lord of the Sabbath, the God of Israel, who heals every disease, look upon your servant, Dominic John. Call out, search out, root out of him every sense of any evil. Put the unclean spirit under the ban. Drive them away, purify the work of your hands. By your vigorous penetrating energy, crush Satan swiftly beneath his feet, and make him victorious over the devil and all his evil spirits, so that, having obtained mercy from you, he may be deemed worthy of your immortal and heavenly mysteries one day, and give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, throughout the ages, of an angel of light during his earthly journey,
who shall rescue him from every snare of adversity, from the encountering of people, from the doomsday demon, and from all evil delusions. Drive off from him, O Lord, every evil spirit, and may all these demons make him swear of the children of God. Drive out from him, O Lord, every evil spirit, and may your life conceal making a threat of evil heart. Drive out from him, O Lord, every evil spirit, and may your life conceal making a threat of evil heart. The spirit of deceit, the spirit of evil, the spirit of idolatry, the spirit of every greed, the spirit of lies, of impurity comes about us at the instigation of the devil. Make him a rational spirit in the whole world and an honorable and member of your church, an heir of your kingdom, not living in accordance with your commandments, preserving the violence and truth of his baptism, and keeping his good baptismal role by his faith.
Thank you. picture you in perfect state in your ineffable love for humankind. We may not become depraved slave of sin. Sovereign Master, you all are good and love mankind. Let me, your humble servant, not be led astray, but send out upon me, on high, the most holy spirit, and strengthen me that I may administer your great and most awesome heavenly mystery which awaits us. Create the image of your Christ in him who seeks to be born again through my unworthiness. Establish him upon the firm foundation of your apostles and prophets, that he may not fall or fail. Cultivate him as a plant of truth in your holy apostolic church, that he may not be uprooted, but rather, as he advances in piety, your most holy name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit may also be glorified through him, now and unto the end of the world. Blessed be God, who desires that all be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. Blessed be he now and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord our God and Master, you call your servant, Dominic John, to your holy illumination of baptism, and deem him worthy of the great grace of your holy baptism. Rid him of that sinful old self, and renew him unto everlasting life. Fill him with the power of the Holy Spirit, uniting him to your Christ, so that he may no longer be only a child of natural descent, but rather a child of your kingdom. Through the benevolence and grace of your begotten Son, of whom you are blessed, together with your most holy delights in your spirit, now and forever and ever. Blessed be our God now, always, and forever and ever. Amen. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Please let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace from on high, the salvation of our souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace throughout the world, well-being of God's holy churches. Unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our holy universal prophets, Benedict 16, our most blessed Christian, our holy commander, our Archbishop, the Father, our Daughter, Bishop John, the venerable priest of the Academy of Christ, all the clergy and the faithful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That this water may be sanctified by the power, the working and the descent of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That the grace of redemption and the blessing of the Jordan may descend upon us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
That the purifying action of the Trinity, supreme and being, may come upon this water. Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
Through the descent of the Holy Spirit, through the descent of the Holy Spirit, we may be illumined with the light of knowledge and piety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That this water may be an effective medicine in averting from every snare of our enemies, both visible and invisible. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he who is to be baptized in this water may be made worthy of the incorruptible kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For him who is now presented for holy baptism and for his salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may prove himself as truly a son and of light and an heir of everlasting happiness and blessings in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may become a member and a partaker of the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, our God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deserve his baptismal robe and his first pledge of the Holy Spirit, pure, undefiled, unto the awesome day of the coming of Christ, our God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
marvelous are your works, and no word is sufficient to sing the praise of your wonders. Great are you, O Lord, and marvelous are your works. No word is sufficient to sing the praise of your wonders.
For by your own goodwill you have brought all things from nothingness into being. By your power you sustain all creation. And by your providence you build the world. You have formed creation from four elements and crown the cycle of the year with four seasons. All the rational powers tremble before you. The sun praises you. The moon glorifies you. The stars converse with you. The light invades you. The deeps tremble before you. The springs of water serve you. You have stretched out the heavens like a curtain. You have bounded the earth upon the waters. Round about the sea you have set barriers of sand. You have poured forth the air for breathing. The angelic powers serve you. The choirs of archangels fall down to worship you. The many-eyed cherubim and six-winged seraphim stand and fly round about you, veiling their faces in fear before your unapproachable glory. For you, being the God who is boundless, eternal, and ineffable, came down upon the earth, taking the form of a servant, and being made in the likeness of man. For you master through your tenderness of your heart of mercy, and did not endure the sight of humankind oppressed by the devil. Instead, you came down and you saved us. We confess your grace, we proclaim your mercy. We do not conceive your goodness. For you have set free the generations of our nation. By your birth, you sanctify the virgin's womb. All creation praises you. You have manifested yourself. For you were seen on earth. You dwelt among us. You howled down the streams of the Jordan. You crushed the heads of the dragons that were therein. By sending down your Holy Spirit from heaven. Therefore, when I am of the King, be present now, also to send in your Holy Spirit, and sanctify this water.
Therefore, O kind and loving King, be present now also through the descent of the Holy Spirit, and sanctify this water. Therefore, O kind and loving King, be present now also through the descent of the Holy Spirit, and sanctify this water. Give this water the grace of redemption, the blessing of the Jordan. Make this water to the bottom of corruption, a gift of sanctification, a remission of sins, a healing of infirmities, a destruction of demons. Make this water to be approachable by hostile powers, and filled with angelic might and life. Let those who conspire together against your creature flee from this water, for I have invoked your name, O Lord. Your name is wonderful and glorious, and terrible adversaries. Let all adverse powers be crushed, let all the adverse powers be crushed beneath the sign of the image of your cross.
Let all the adverse powers be crushed beneath the sign of the image of your cross. Let all the adverse powers be crushed beneath the sign of the image of your cross. We pray you, O Lord, that every unseen phantom in the air is drawn from us. Let no demon of darkness conceal himself in this water. Let no evil spirits bring hidden purpose or rebellious thoughts. Go down into this water with Dominic John, who is about to be baptized. Instead, master of all, declare this water to be a water of redemption, a water of sanctification, the cleansing of flesh and spirit, the loosing of bonds, the forgiveness of sins, the illumination of the soul, the back of regeneration, the renewal of the spirit, the gift of adoption, the garden of incorruption, and the fountain of life. For you, O Lord, have said, wash and be clean. Put away evil from your soul.
the water and the spirit that have given us the generation from on high. Manifest yourself, O Lord, in this water, and grant that we would be baptized, and be transformed into this water, putting away the old man, and putting on the new. Be moved according to the image of him who created him. God granted to baptism in the likeness of your death. He may one day be a sharer in your resurrection. Reserve the gift of the Holy Spirit, and increasing the deposit of grace, may he gain the prize of his high calling, and be counted in the number of the firstborn, whose names are written in heaven. And you, our God and Lord Jesus Christ, who will be glory, dominion, together with your eternal Father, the most holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Peace be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads to the Lord.
To you, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord and Master, God of all creation and those who know him are above, bearing an olive branch in his beak as a sign of reconciliation and salvation from the flood, thereby prefiguring the mystery of grace, you have given us all of this oil for the celebration of your holy mysteries. And by the anointing with the olive oil, you fill those under the law with the Holy Spirit. And now by this anointing, you bring to perfection those under the grace of your Christ. We ask you to bless this oil, that it may be an ointment of incorruption and a weapon of righteousness, the renewal of soul and body, the expulsion of every diabolic activity, and a deliverance from evil for those who are anointed with it in faith. We ask you that this oil be blessed by the power and the descent, the action of the Holy Spirit. For unto your glory, we ask that you do this, that of your begotten Son, the most holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen. Gospel.
them, and always act righteously, and always bless the Lord.
Thank you.
and we commentate your good works and words, so that when the Lord comes to you, you may walk in peace and radiance together with all the saints, and enter unhindered into his heavenly glory, and be with him forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Blessed are you, Lord God, a mighty source of good things, Son of righteousness. You shine the light of darkness and the light of our darkness. As a manifestation of your only begotten Son, and worthy of all we need, you have given us the blessed purification in holy water, the divine consecration in the life-giving of anointing. You are now graciously pleased to have regenerated your newly illumined servant by water and the Spirit. You have granted him the remission of original sin. O Master and gentle, harnessing them all, grant him also the seal of the gift of your holy, almighty, and adorable Spirit. The communion of your holy, of the holy body and precious blood of your Christ. Keep him in your sanctification. Confirm him in Catholic faith. Deliver him from the evil one from all his coming. Reserve his soul in purity and righteousness by his sanitary awe of you, that by pleasing you in his word and deeds, he may truly be a son and heir to your heavenly kingdom. You are our God, the God who shows mercy and saves, and we give glory to you with your eternal Father, the Holy Good and Righteous Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
From the letter of the Holy Apostle to the Romans.
And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some of them doubted. Jesus then drew near and spoke to them, saying, all authority in heaven and on earth has been handed to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them to carry out all that I have taught you, and know that I will be with you always in the Spirit, even to the end of the world.
Glory be to you, Lord. Glory be to you.
Just want to say to all of you my best wishes on this special day. I remind you that Dominic John is no longer a child of your family lineages, but a child of God, very close to God now. As a baby, he has done nothing. He's an angel, and his angelic powers, we could say, have been really brought to life by being baptized, confirmed, and receiving the Lord in the Eucharist, which you will receive soon, the blood, precious blood of Christ. So I say to you that all of the power of God has come into him, the three persons of the Trinity come to him, and he is truly now a son and an heir of our Father in heaven and an heir to the kingdom. I pray for him. God give him many healthy, happy years to serve him. And I pray for all of you that God will keep you in good health and strength for many years to help his needs, to help him grow. You saw how he just what I was looking at him now as he was had the pacifier and his hand up like this, how immediate of someone to care for him. How defenseless, how helpless is the little baby, and how the heart goes out to want to take care of him and watch over him. Just as it was now, it will be as we soon relive the birth of Jesus, who became a baby and was one with us and lived through our human life. So I pray that God's Spirit is to be able to take care of all his needs and keep you for many years in much health and strength. Now we're going to continue with this with the service and finish before everything is concluded with this ceremony. It's a very special ceremony for Dominic John, the day of his baptism, confirmation, and reception of the Eucharist. Let us say, with our whole soul, with our whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for the world, universal pocket, that it keeps speaking over the world. Our own blessed patriarch, our holy governor, Archbishop of Paul, and Stefan, our God, our Bishop John, who is always concerned about us, this holy church, for our spiritual fathers, all our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Of our nation under God, I help to make all the service of our country.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Pray that the Holy Spirit serve us up. Dominic John, we pray for him on this special day, that he may be preserved in the pure profession of his faith, in piety and fulfilling the commandments of Christ in his church all the days of his life. Please hear, Lord, hear us, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
blood of Christ is shed by your servant Dominic John unto life everlasting.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord Almighty, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who by your word created all and brought from nothing all that we have into be, we pray, we beseech, and we implore you to keep from all error and harm your servant Mary, over whom you have watched, and who has now come to your holy church to render thanks to you. And do thou bless, O Lord, this child. Sanctify this child. Enable Dominic John to reach maturity. Endow him with understanding, with prudence, and wisdom. And since you have brought him into this world and shown him the natural light of day, grant that at a time appointed by you, he may be accounted worthy of the supernatural light of heaven and be included within all those who are there now for the sake of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed together with your most holy, gracious, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever and ever. Amen. Enter into the house of God. Adore the Son of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Adore him who has granted that you would bear a child. May the peace and blessing come down upon you, Mary, you, Dominic, and you, Dominic John, Jr., by the calling down of the Spirit and by the sprinkling of this water, blessed and sanctified by the Lord. May God's blessings be with you now and always. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to you, O Christ, our God, our hope. Glory be to you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Give a blessing.
Servant Dominic John, newly illumined through baptism, chrismation, and the reception of the Eucharist, grant to him, to his parents and godparents, and all the family, many healthy and happy years. Nam noi blahirita.
No, I am. many years, many happy years. God grant him many years, many happy years. In health and salvation, in health and salvation. God grant him many happy years.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Dominic and Mary, on the occasion of your child, Dominic John, on his baptism, the Knights of Columbus Pokrova Council, and Pokrova stands for Protection of the Mother of God, and that's the image of Our Lady over there, who is Pokrova. We'd like to pay honor and tribute to motherhood as part of our program to foster the right to life. As you know, a red rose signifies many things to many people. And to us, it's not just love, but it's the love of that life that's just been given to both of you. So with that, we'd like to present to you an honorary remembrance of this, which is a silk lace rose laced with the Rosary of Our Blessed Lady and a message from the late John Paul II, our Pope. Normally, I'd invite the man to join the knights, but you already are a
knight.
And we also like to welcome and thank you for choosing life, for having your parents having chosen life, and also the grandparents, whether they're here or not, for having chosen life. Because if they didn't, that chain wouldn't be, and we wouldn't have that little boy over here. To give you an example of that, I know a lady who in 1947, at age 38, 6 months pregnant, was told that she should abort her child. And on Christmas Eve, she went in to the hospital to see if she could save that child. Because the doctor had feared that she would lose her life. And she did die. She did die. But she was 91 years old when she died. And her friends called her Genevieve, and I called her Mom. Okay. Thank you very much, Father Greg.
Okay, now. You're all done.
Thank you.